Hola, hola, hola. Buenos días, buenas tardes, buenas noches, depending on what part of the world you're joining us. Thank you so much for joining us today. Bienvenidos a todos. We are so glad you're here for our community conversation, where today's topic, Anne, is going to be expanding our hearts and minds through literature. I'm super, super excited. We are very excited for this conversation today, where our amazing panelists will be sharing titles ranging and from modern topics like courage, empathy, diversity, STEAM, LGBTQ, I'm sorry, LGBTQ community. I'm super excited. I cannot even talk ni en inglés ni en español, and much more. I'm super, super happy to be here with you all.
Oh my gosh, friend, I'm excited for this conversation too. I'm to be honest, for our friends listening in, I'm having a fangirl moment. I am obsessed with our guest and the work that she's doing. I have gone on a deep dive listening to every podcast that she's been on. I have one more surprise for her she doesn't know about. But friends, as Feli mentioned, tonight we're talking about books and the power of stories and how they can expand hearts and minds. And I love that the mission of the work that our guest and the company that she founded is all about empowering people through story. And that aligns so beautifully with our mission at Flipgrid to empower every person on the planet to share their voice and respect the diverse voices of others. So we do believe books and stories and literature can expand hearts and minds, help us learn about others, gain insight and empathy, and help us all come together in new ways. So, Feli, I know you're excited. I'm excited too.
I'm excited. I can't wait. And what do you think if we bring her to our audience? Let's do it.
Friends, please welcome Maria Dismondi. And Maria, welcome, welcome, welcome. Founder of Cardinal Rule Press, author, speaker, mama, eater of spaghetti in a hot dog bun, which I love, founder of Cardinal Rule Press, and so much more. Welcome to this community conversation.
Thank you. I'm so happy to be here and to be part of something that is so positive and genuine for children. So thanks for inviting me.
Well, I just mentioned I've gone on a deep dive every podcast I can find that you've been a guest on, and there are many. I have spent the last few weeks listening, and I just thought, she's a kindred spirit. One, you're a former educator. I'd love to know more about your story, and we're going to get there. Two, you are an author, a speaker, and you founded this company called Cardinal Rule Press. So you're a publisher putting out content into the world that's making a difference in people's lives. And we are honored to have you on for this conversation.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
I think that's a great place to start. Could you share a little bit about the mission of Cardinal Rule Press, the work that you're doing, your story, and how you get these powerful messages into the world through realistic fiction?
Absolutely. So this is probably the part that you've heard before in my podcast interviews, but I was a teacher. I taught first and second grade for over a decade. And I realized one day when I was going to read my students a story, well, I searched high and low. We didn't have Amazon or Google at the time. I probably went to the library and, you know, searched the shelves looking for a book that talked about courage and being yourself. And I could find books about dinosaurs that were talking and, you know, fish that were singing and dancing, but I couldn't find books that had real kids in them. And that's when I wrote Spaghetti and Hot Dog Bun. The book was actually loosely based on my own experiences as a kid. I really did eat spaghetti and a hot dog bun. I still do today. And I was teased for it. I was teased for my hair. I was teased for, you know, my voice. I was teased for being short, all these different things. And I just really felt like I could connect with the kids with the story. So it came into the world in 2008. And oh, there it is, there it is. And I just continued to write. And at one point I had to make a decision. We were starting a family. I had to decide, am I going to continue both or am I gonna choose one? And so I chose to resign from teaching, and I still kept my foot in the door through speaking engagements as an author. And then after a while, I didn't really want to have myself in the limelight anymore. I wanted to give this opportunity and this gift to share these powerful messages to others. And that's when I founded Cardinal Wool Press.
Oh my gosh. And Maria, I know I picked this up, but like one of the things that I'm obsessed with is the work that you're doing and the stories that you have authored, but everything has this powerful message. So this, the experience of your personal life, but the message of having the courage to be who you are. And I think that's something that Feli and I know we're proud that to be on a team at Flipgrid that is empowering and celebrating and honoring the diverse nature of this global community we have the honor of working in. And that's why your stories resonate. They're real, they're relevant, they're tangible life experiences, your lived experience that somebody who's finding the story in the pages of these books can relate to.
Yeah, and it's been really important to me to stick with that. We had over 1,400 submissions in the last open submissions period, and we are only accepting realistic fiction. So it's really important to us to stick with that.
Oh, and one of the things that I was talking to Anne about this is that this is children's literature, which is beautiful. Every topic, it's a celebration of who the kids are. But I was also telling Anne that also it's a story that might help us too. Not only children books, but it's some of these messages. I'm not going to say some. I'm going to say all of these messages are stories that are also in our hearts, right? Mm-hmm. That the kid that we always lives here and that brings those experiences, right? That we sometimes, because of the everyday life, we might forget, right? But when I was reading these books, I was like, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, and it reminded me of the kid in me, la niña en mí, que tendemos a olvidar a veces. And again, it's just beautiful. Thank you so much for doing this for our kids, for our students, for our babies, but for everyone in this planet.
For everyone. And thank you, Feli. And I've heard that from parents that, you know, not only are these messages for their children, but they're also for all of us. I have positive affirmations on phone. My middle schooler helped set up some fun widgets. I mean, this is something that we're always working on. We're always trying to accept and love ourselves. And I think in society today, it feels like it's getting harder and harder with the way things are going. And so I'm going to fight harder and harder to create this legacy of books that can teach and books that can really make a difference.
I love that. And honoring the story, Feli, I'm putting Feli on the spot too. We've talked about this book in particular, Chocolate Milk, Por Favor. And at the end, this is the sweetest story about a young boy named Gabe who comes as an English learner and is finding his way, communicating with new classmates, classroom dynamics, personality conflicts, and learning about friendship. But I love that the lasting message is celebrating diversity with empathy. And then let's take a moment and meet the real Gabe. This was your student. I'm about to cry also, right? Honoring the stories and the people of these lasting messages. So this boy inspired you to share this story with the world that we all can take and use to learn and honor and celebrate with empathy the diverse community that surrounds us.
Yeah, and kids love that story because he's a real person. I tell them it's the real Gabe. There he is, but he doesn't look like that anymore. He's a grown boy. He's a grown boy, yeah. So that story was really important to me. And, you know, I noticed he came to my classroom on, I think, like the third day that he was living in the United States. He was so scared, and he didn't know any English. And the children in the classroom, their actions spoke so much louder than their words. And he became fluent in English. He was so loved by their communication. And it wasn't verbal communication. And so it's a good reminder that the way we treat people, not just with our words, but waving hello, thumbs up, okay, a pat on the back, all of those things matter, and all of those things make a difference, especially when we're dealing with diversity and not just people who are speaking a different language, but people who are differently abled. There are so many different ways to describe diversity.
Yes, and also I wanted to thank you for showing the two perspectives. Because when I was reading the book, I was like, I saw myself in your student, in that kid, and I saw my babies, my students as well. Like, and it's so important to see the two perspectives. I was always telling my babies, my students, we need to open our eyes, but we need to open our heart as well and look at the two perspectives. And this book is amazing at what it does. It talks about the two perspectives so that you're able to understand the feelings from the different characters and the different people, and then get into a situation where everybody is happy and everybody agrees. But I wanted to thank you for writing this book about one of your students. It's a great honor for the student. It's like a tribute, un tributo for your student. So I can only imagine how that baby feels, like the how proud he feels. And that's exactly what I was telling Ann, that's exactly what needs to happen in the classroom. We need to make our students, our babies, feel proud of who they are, the language they speak. And it doesn't matter how they speak or the so famous accent, right, that we come to the United States with, and it's just showing them that they have a space here, that they have a voice, and that is respected and it's appreciated. So I personally want to thank you for this book, but I want to personally thank you for writing the book about a real person, a real kid, a real EL student. So thank you again so much. I'm super excited. Mira cómo estoy. Look.
Me too. And you know, it went even further because a production company took that story and they turned it into a children's musical. So that story has traveled across the country to different schools as a musical, which I gotta be honest, it's so much better than the book. There's music and dancing, so.
Oh, what a beautiful extension of the message that every voice is valued, every voice matters. Your unique self is honored and recognized and seen and celebrated. Maria, I would love to talk about some more of your titles because you're sharing these lasting messages. And I love, love, love on your website, and we will share your website in just a little bit towards the end when we share resources, but you have this statement about sharing realistic, representative books for socially thoughtful children. And I'd love to dig into what that means, some of the titles, et cetera. If you haven't guessed yet, I have all of your books here on my desk. So not only like The Juice Box Bully, The Jelly Donut Difference. I know you and I spoke about this one months ago when we first connected. Goodness gracious, The Fruit Salad Friend. And of course, the one that I have here, The Potato Chip Champ. And then one of the sweetest ones that's just captured our hearts, Dazzling Travis. So I would love to know more about these titles, the lasting messages. You know, from you, the publisher, you, the author, and you, this woman on a mission to help share these stories.
Absolutely. So Dazzling Travis is published by Cardinal Rule Press, written by Hannah Carmona. And Hannah, actually, she ran a children's theater company for years, and she had a personal experience. And again, if you turn to the back of the book while I'm talking, you can see that she was also inspired by a student. And so this story was, again, teachers, we are inspired by our students, and I just think it's so powerful. Her student loved to dance, and he's a male dancer. And so that's who Travis is. And he doesn't stop doing what he loves. There's the student that she was inspired by, Seth. And he doesn't stop doing what he loves. He's original. He's brave. People tease him for who he is, but he continues to be himself. Now, we did not write this story with the intent for it to be an LGBTQ book, but it has been widely accepted and beloved by the community. And they are just thanking us because it gives other children the courage to be who they are. You know, whether or not you're part of the lesbian gay community, you are going to want to do what you love, and you're going to want to be accepted for who you are. So maybe you just like pink, or maybe you, you know, like to play with cars and you're a little girl. But just being able to show children that, and you know, there are several books, which I think is wonderful. So if you're a teacher out there, take Dazzling Travis, pair it up with something like Sparkle Boy, pair it up with another book, compare, contrast, or find a female protagonist and find a female character that you can compare and contrast with, and just really dive deeper into that diversity and that we all want to be accepted for who we are.
And that's that timeless, lasting message with maybe a modern twist, as everybody is, you know, has the freedom of expression and being yourself, but the story about being confident, being original. And I love on the back, even the back cover asking, will Travis remain brave when others tease him for being different? These are conversations that work at so many grade levels, but also have the power to open community mindset about empathy, celebration, friendship, kindness, so many different things. You relate courage and confidence. And those are these life skills that are so interwoven into the academic journey, right? That life. We share life in our classrooms with our students. So why wouldn't we help them explore being courageous or using their voice or being confident in who they are? So this, and yes, seeing Travis's face back here, not only with other inspiring folks, but this sweet face about the inspiration for the story too. Oh my God, I love it.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
And I'm always going to say that when our students feel comfortable in our classroom, that's when the learning happens. I love what you said about, well, read this book and bring this one, compare and contrast, right? And what a better way to teach literature, to teach reading, everything that our objectives, right, our curriculum ask us for, than with real stories and stories that are going to be connected and have a real meaning to our students' hearts. Because it's relevant topics, and it's something that it's happening, and those are the conversations that they want to have, that they might not, those conversations might not be happening at home, and they feel comfortable enough because you as a teacher have created those relationships, and your classroom is like a shelter for them, so they feel comfortable to talk about these topics, and it's excellent. It's so beautiful to bring, like, to kill, how do you say it in English?
Two birds with one stone.
Yes, there you go. Dos por el precio de uno, two for the price of one. That's how we say it in Spanish. And right now, my English and my Spanish are fighting in my brain. But it's two for the price of one, right? Because the stories are relevant and the learning is also happening. So you're really, 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 really caring about your kids. You are teaching them what you need to teach them according to the grade level that they're in, but you're also having these conversations with them. So once again, thank you. My oldest son is a dancer. So I also, when I read this book, I was like, because yes.
And you know, I just want to say to both of you, I'm definitely practicing what I preach. So I don't want those listening thinking, oh my goodness, well, Maria, you've been, you know, away from the classroom for 12 years. I actually popped back into the classroom full time for the last 6 weeks of school. So I just got out of school, and it was a really great opportunity at my children's elementary school to do reading intervention. And the state of Michigan put a call out. They needed teachers, and they were going to waive my expired certificate. And I said, I'm headed in. I'm doing it. And it just reminded me, we live in a county that nationwide is known for, I guess it's a little bit more of an affluent community, but within the schools, you don't see that. You see children who, you know, I think we have over 60% of free and reduced lunch. I mean, our kids are having struggles at home, and it's so easy to forget that when we're in our own bubble. So for me to step back into that situation, it was reminded of how important teachers are. You are the light of these children's lives, and you are the heart. And so what you're giving to them, they are using that as a social tool. oftentimes to survive at home. And I was reminded of that the last 6 weeks.
That's phenomenal that you went and did that. And I stand beside you in the echo. Teachers are doing heroic work. And especially in a time where so much is unprecedented with a shift due to a pandemic and circumstances that impact so many things. So I love that you were able to do that and serve in that way, and echo the biggest shout and cheer for the work that educators are doing.
And for Flipgrid, in the sense, because you're bringing all of these opportunities that some children don't have, most children don't have. I mean, your field trips, and I'm going to give a commercial now for Flipgrid, but you are bringing so many opportunities, and like this opportunity for teachers to be able to say to a publisher, hey, could you have, you know, content on this, this, and this for our classroom? We're willing to do that for you. I think making the connections has been really huge for Flipgrid, and especially in this time. So it's been a lifesaver for so many teachers.
Thank you. That is kind and generous. Thank you. Thank you. Well, speaking of content and speaking of incredible folks sharing content, I'm going to skip ahead. We have other questions for you, but I'm going to go ahead and share my screen because I do want to let folks know you are sharing phenomenal resources inside the Flipgrid Discovery Library. So folks who are familiar with Flipgrid, or if you're just getting started, this is built in to your educator account. You simply navigate to the section called Discovery and check it out. Featured right here on the front page, Cardinal Rule Press. But I want to show you, if you are looking for this content, we have different grade content areas, so many resources created by fellow educators around the world, as well as featured partners. And so when you click on the partners right here, look for this gorgeous icon, Cardinal Rule Press, and you click on it and get right to your Discovery Library page. Maria, as the founder of this company and bringing in authors and sharing these stories, we'd love to hear from you about what folks can use and find when they go to your content inside the Discovery Library.
For sure. Yeah. So we've actually asked all of our authors to record videos about their inspiration in writing the stories. So I think that's a really great piece of content to help for a writer's workshop and to inspire students to hear, okay, how does an author of a picture book get inspired to write realistic fiction? We also have illustrators sharing about their creative process in there, which is so great for kids who are interested in sketching and drawing. We have read alouds. We also have read alouds that are in American Sign Language, which is also very important to us. We're trying to make sure that there's access to all. We're trying to partner with a Braille company to get our books in Braille as well. We also have, let's see, Meet the Author Inspiration Lesson Plan. So we have these reader guides that are completely free. They have 10 lessons with the Common Core standards, all of the, everything you need, the principles, everything you need right there, print it out, you can assign it to students. And we'd love to be able to connect, you know, authors with students. And so whatever you need or whatever you want, please reach out to us and say, hey, we'd love to have this kind of content there. Our authors are willing to, you know, be in touch, and virtual visits. We're constantly doing that. We're working with libraries as well. So we have a lot to offer.
A lot to offer. And I just want to
say one more thing.
Please,
you know,
please.
What I really like is we put our book trailers on there. And so that's like a 60-second video that's about a story that, you know, one of our books. And those have been really fun. I've heard from teachers, they're giving kids the opportunity after they've written a realistic fiction piece, they then have the kids in Media Center create their own book trailer. So these book trailers are, and there's not a ton if you look on YouTube, but these book trailers are specific to picture books, realistic fiction, so they could model their own off of that.
Yeah. So you are speaking right to my heart. That was something I was doing. I grew up watching, you know, a book talk at the end of Reading Rainbow as a child and was doing that with students in my classroom. And so I'm clicking through these. So our friends who are tuning and watching in, I'm going to slow this down for just a moment because I'm so excited. I'm just going to click on everything. I want to show you everything. But here inside the Cardinal Rule Press page, you can find their popular topics, the collection. So we talk about timeless stories on sportsmanship, empathy and kindness, being you, going beyond character counts, STEM and diversity. And so inside these collections, as she just mentioned, hearing from the author, for goodness sake, how cool is that? Hannah Carmona right here talking about her life, her inspiration for this book, the affirmations she's using. As a man, as an adult and a lifelong learner, I'm geeking out with excitement about this. Hearing from the authors, the illustrators, I did also notice, and Feli and I have talked about this, but you're providing content in Espanol también, right? So like if your author, if your illustrator happens to be a speaker of another language, what a beautiful way to honor their voice and have them sharing in multilingual capacities, right? I love your topics.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. And that just reminded me, I mean, we have books that are translated in Korean and we have another one, we have Spanish, Korean, and Mandarin. I feel like we could probably have them read in those languages as well. We need to get on that. Let me write that down.
One other thing, Maria, too, like for example, specifically with you and spaghetti and a hot dog bun, I remember this book on my bookshelf in my classroom. And this is where I'm gonna get caught up right in my feels. Like, but you in these topics too, meeting you and coming in, hey, awesome background. By the way, I love how you have your books arranged behind you. But like you're doing read alouds of your book. So this is one way that educators, if they don't have the physical book, they can still share it and bring the stories to life in their classrooms with this content, with your authors, with your illustrators. What a beautiful way that you're sharing this content literally around the world.
Thank you, thank you. It's been a lot of fun. And like I said, I actually have been using Flipgrid with my own children. I've been using it with online classes that I've taught about character and kindness. And so I'm a user and I'm also a partner too.
Oh my gosh. Well, I do want to take a moment also and share this, your website as well. So folks who are looking to explore more, definitely check out cardinalrulepress.com. One of the things I know I've kind of scrolled through here, but talking about books that make a difference. I mean, you're making waves and doing incredible things, sharing resources for folks all over the place. But I love, love, love that you're sharing incredible resources for people to dig deeper and without getting people seasick by scrolling so quickly. I want to say like meeting our creatives, right? What a great way to meet the team of folks who are sharing these stories and bringing these words to life to help so many. So friends, definitely check out CardinalRulePress.com. Maria, can we go to a few more questions?
Yes, yes, go for it. I'll try to answer quickly for time's sake.
Well, I'm curious. We've talked about these powerful things, but in your words, what makes a great story?
Authenticity, passion. So I'm always telling children, you dig right into the heart of the matter. So tug at those heartstrings, pull those heartstrings out, figure out what is your passion? Find that love, find that heart, and be authentic. Be yourself when you're writing, and don't be afraid. Just jump right into it. I am constantly making mistakes. So for those of you tuning in, constantly making mistakes. I go back, fix my mistake, I learn from it, try not to make it again. So mistakes are not a bad thing. Remember that.
Brilliant advice, brilliant advice. Speaking of advice, what advice do you have for teachers, parents, families in the community? It is a, we're all on a mission to empower young people as we move forward as lifelong learners. But what is some advice you have to share with folks?
Well, I think teachers are in a position to make a huge impact. And so my hope and my challenge for you is to adopt a picture book a day. And I think even the teachers who are teaching fourth and fifth grade, a picture book a day. Start your morning off with a picture book. SEL, social emotional learning, our kids need it. It's not always being taught in the homes. It's not always being taught in the schools. It's not part of the curriculum. So bring it into your morning meetings. Read a 5-minute picture book. Get some questions. Your kids will start talking. And that's where the magic happens. Because I think one of you shared, if you can create that community in your classroom and that safe space for your students, they're going to absorb all of that content and information you're teaching them that much better. And they're going to walk away from whatever grade level you're teaching, and they're going to feel like they are important, they are loved. And when you feel that way, you are that much better out in the world. Picture book a day, everybody. Picture book a day.
I love that. I love that. That's what I miss from my own classroom, Feli. I don't know about you, but when I think about the time that I spent in the classroom and the moments I just treasure, it was sharing stories with my students. And when I'm invited to read books to classrooms or get to go into classrooms, that's one of my favorite things. I mean, besides sharing Flipgrid, of course, I absolutely love a shared story, and upper elementary kids too. Older elementary students, everybody loves a story, no matter what age.
No matter what age, that's exactly right, Anne. And also from a middle school teacher perspective, eighth grade specifically, they love read alouds. They want to be loved, and they want to be your baby. So I remember telling my students at the beginning of class, just with like a book, a short story, I'm going to read for you. Mm-hmm. We're going to learn from it. We're going to talk about it. And then the learning happens. It does not matter how old you are. Even for us, I read aloud to my 19-year-old, and then he reads aloud to me, and we have these beautiful conversations about whatever book we're talking about. Same thing with my 15-year-old. Read alouds are magical.
They're magical, and you know, tomorrow we're talking with a whole bunch of authors from LGBTQ read alouds or picture books. And we're sharing that with families, and we're just opening up the communication with families and education about that topic. And we're talking about how books can truly open up the door for conversation. And that's what's important, is kids sometimes are afraid to have that conversation, but the books lend itself to teaching. So a book a day, everybody.
I love it. And with that, I think that wraps so perfectly. A book a day, you, the work that you are doing at Cardinal Rule Press, the stories you are putting out into the world are expanding hearts and minds through literature. So Maria, we just want to say thank you so much for taking the time to come on to share. I mean, I am a book hugger. I love them. I just appreciate the messages, kindness, confidence, courage, empathy, diversity, celebration, and empowering and honoring diverse voices. So thank you, thank you, thank you.
Friends. You're welcome. You're welcome.
Oh my gosh. We appreciate you. And friends, we want to thank you for tuning in. Feli, I know we have one other resource to share real quick. We can't miss an opportunity to share this. I have to share my stream real quick. What's coming up, Feli? June 28th. Everyone's invited.
Everyone is invited. If you haven't registered for this amazing event, we are going to have this June 28th. Please do so. No se lo pueden perder. Everything that is coming to Flipgrid is just going to be more amazing than it already is. And trust me, everything that has been built into Flipgrid and continues to get better is with our babies, with our students, in our minds, in our hearts. So everything that this amazing team is doing for our students is just priceless. So please, let me get my glasses back. please register for this event. It's going to be awesome. Vamos a estar hablando inglés, vamos a estar hablando español, and we're going to share stories with you, stories that are from here, from our corazones, from our heart. Maria, once again, an honor to meet you, an honor to have you here. Thank you for everything. Thank you for sharing all of these topics to our Discovery Library. Thank you for sharing this with teachers, but most importantly, for every single one of the students that we have in every single school en todo el planeta, and the entire planet. Thank you to your team as well. Muchísimas gracias. Un gran honor.
Thank you. Together we can do this.
Thank you. And everybody tuning in, please stay safe, take care, and we'll see you out there. Bye.
Gracias a nuestra comunidad. Besos a todos.